Alright, so right now we're going to play this video. Brief montage about mind control. The audio commentary. So here I see a dude that I want to know that I want to mind control off of the video script. Now first of all, I know that when I filmed the first time I've ever done mind control, it's recorded, so I'm a little bit nervous. But when in doubt, just start feeling stuff, right? So, go to cast mind control, it's done here. So I want to do it as soon as the next gun rolls off, but I'm also really nervous, and of course that means I have to push on the keys. So I go off the mind control again, and by now I realize I need to do it. Here we go. That's no fair! This really... Okay, so I've got the mic control off and it landed, and the target here, so I don't really do much like that. That's the thing about mic control, it is a lot more difficult than people really understand. It's not as simple as just casting a spell, and all of a sudden you have awesome video shows up. A lot of times you'll be casting a spell 4 or 5 times to land. I got away from it. Here we go. Another one lands right as the sheep lands. And that's my control of the sheep. I'll be picking up the way I want. So I try to go ahead and control it again. See, this is once I think I missed the second card that it landed. And here we go. Actually managed to get him off the ground. He actually died. See the panda camera here. Body. This end, beautiful lady, right after it, so perfect execution. That's a good time. You know why? Because I actually managed to get the first cast off. So if that went, you thought it was my friend did the best cast off. Ironically enough, I think I end up mind-controlling her 2 more times. Oh, yes! There she is, again. Let's see. I tell this guy to get her low, so that when I mind-control her off the edge, it'll actually go through, and she'll die when she lands, because it's only perfect if they die upon landing. Up to that point, it's just, yay, you can't hurt me anymore, and I can recuperate or hide or whatever I need to do. Okay, so I end up mind controlling her off the edge again, but she doesn't die. I was already in spirit form by then, and so it was ironic. I thought that I had not released mind control fast enough, and that had caused me to die, but that's not the case. So anyway, here she is a third time at the same spot, and I end up getting the mind controller again. Successfully, actually. Actually had to do a little bit of healing in this game. I hate it when I have to do my class role. Instead of doing my own thing. No, I didn't manage to mind control again. But anyway, here's another guy. Walked him off the edge beautifully. And of course he didn't die. Because I got it off the first cast. But you know what Murphy's Law says? If anything bad can happen, it will happen. Therefore, if anything good can happen, it will eventually happen too. So if anything bad can happen, anything good can happen. So I had 2 times to walk this guy off unsuccessfully. Three times around and probably just killed on the teammates, but not everything went badly. So perfect first one, landed, let go. And okay, so that's what a death grip does halfway through. I gotta give him props on how quick he was in that death grip. That's insanely quick reaction time. I won't have really been mind controlled and walked off a cliff, but It does take that to be a keybind. To be a pro melee, you have to have keybind, not clicker. So he got me down here. A lot of good it eventually ended up doing him, but that just showed how pro he was. Do you ever watch this? Oh, yeah. Okay, so I have two up here. No, three. Okay, one of them is leaving. That leaves two. That's not so bad. I've done it before. I don't know what, but... ooh, it just got better. One of them left. This is going to be so... that timing was down to the half second, I believe. This here will force him to get out of his bubble. So... once I'm out, I heal up a little bit. Put a shield and a renew on. No, just breathing. Try to get a shield up before I do anything. Yeah, there we go. Okay. Now, mind control. And miss. So, that's not surprising at all. Here, we'll try again. And it is it. This is true. I don't know. Try the third time. This will bring him back anyway. Power word chastise, mind control, ran off too soon. And that stinks because the second time around their CC duration is much shorter, so I try to run away and not CC them again until I have the full 8-second duration. And I do mind control, and here I end up doing it's actually right for once. Mind control, let him go, and he didn't die. He had about second salvation left. I believe he was, I don't know what he used, but either way. I don't think it was a very long fall. Helped me cap though. Or someone else cap. Yeah, the guy had snuck up there and capped while I was busy doing that. It just props to the teammates and I'm just staring at and watching. Anyway, right here I have the honor of waving goodbye at him and giggling. So here, I go to cap, someone's already capped it. Because I realize there's fighting, so why not just go ahead and shoot him from the back? I just don't understand why someone would stand there by the flag fighting and not even pay attention to the flag. So once I was so happy that I had that recorded on tape, I had to push a few more unnecessary buttons, and then realized that I may be able to do another one. So here we go, second one, and that actually landed on the first try. And off the edge we go. Wonderfully done. Actually died too. Teammate decided, hey, I can't let someone die alone. Jump off the edge with him. Suicide mission. Try to mind control someone else here. See if it'll work. Some half-hearted heals. Meantime. I do like spirit healers for him a lot. Okay, so here we have a DK. Thinks he's all that more. If usually you're gonna kill me, you're gonna be able to do it within the first 20 seconds. If not, chances are you're not gonna be able to kill me. And then off the edge he goes. Quite beautifully, actually. In spite of the fact that he sort of free-falled, hitting one little edge after another. I didn't know you could mind control boom cannons. So this has all been just to prove how random and uneventful and unperfect it can be mind control sometimes. It can be very easy and done beautifully in the most amazing circumstances. It can also make you want to quit playing a priest and saying, hey, it's more fun to be a hunter and kill this car from a distance. But how good are you? How good is your gear? And how much of a card are you? Now this guy came back after and mind controlled him off the edge because he was afraid he would die. So he came back up and we made sure he died. Get away. I love it when they do that. I'm so OP, I can take on 19 of these. Here we see me get the mind control, a target off the edge for no other reason than crowd control. I'm gonna fear that guy. So this is how it goes, how it is to perfectly set up someone to get mind controlled off the edge and out of the storm. Make them follow you to a place where you can crowd control in 1 or 2 seconds. Hopefully it lands, and then you get to do this. There's no way they can live through that. Into the eternal abyss. Goodbye. You have to, hopefully, though, get them alone, and you have to get them close enough to the edge. Here, one landed right as I died and went into spirit form. I didn't know you could do that. I started laughing so hard, I almost burned myself with my cigarette. Oh, shaman, didn't get to blast me off the edge. Oh yeah, you're resto, you have the flag. Let me make sure I get you off the edge with the flag. There we go. Hey, right off the edge, right between all of them, and to your demise. Oh, there's nothing more beautiful than that. Escape from the enemies down here. Just gotta do a little healing. There's no way they can get me now. Here, I positioned myself perfectly just for this reason, and not a second later, he showed up and allowed me to mind control him off the edge.